And welcome to another game. Maybe I should just let the intro go, but we're going to be translating this intro. Love is the strongest conqueror in the world. Anything stronger than love dies. Fame conquers death. Time destroys fame. What wins at times is the strongest thing in the world. Some guy from the past. Neat. So this is a game by Takara, and what we're going to be seeing is not going to be the most clear introduction, so I'll explain it after. Alright, you understood what is happening, right? So this is Die Katze von Schroedinger, or in Japanese, Schroedinger no Neko. Or I guess it'd be Schroedinger no Neko. Yeah. Anyway, we're gonna be doing a new game. So what happened in the in that intro scene? We are playing as a 16-year-old girl who has just moved to a new town. She sees a cat. The cat runs away, and she follows the cat. That might not have been clear from that intro scene. So we're going to be kind of playing that out right here. So we have ended up in a church. It is dark and somewhat spooky. Feels like cold air is blowing from somewhere. And we're just going to be trying out this game for maybe an hour. I wonder where Schrodinger is gone. So she doesn't know this cat, I don't think. Unless it's her cat. Schrodinger. So it's not really Schrodinger's cat. It's the cat named Schrodinger. So here we go. We can move around. Can also pick up items. This is a torch. Got the torch. Oh, and the other thing we're going to want to do is immediately change the message speed. So I believe this is the settings menu. And then is it this one? Function. Message speed immediate. That other stuff, not that important. At least not for right now. You can always check it out later. Alright, so there are these panels here. We can talk to those, but We don't need to. This right here is cumin. We can look down. And I imagine we're going to be doing some of that. Okay, we are looking for basil, I think. Is there basil over here? We can run. We can also strafe. There it is. Basil leaves. Why do we care about this stuff? Well, we can talk to the magic mirror here. We'll get a weird face, and he'll give us a tutorial. Basil leaves restore health. So that's why we care. There's a whole bunch of boring statues. There is this thing. This is a save point. We don't want the save point. So we're gonna come right over here. And there is this mysterious thing. That's cool. Oh yeah, there's some stuff on the floor. Let's pick up this. This is the compass. That will give us a HUD. And we get a key. Key doesn't do anything right now. Now, maybe there's a puzzle to using this key. I'm not sure, but if we come over here, there is a symbol. I don't know if that relates to the key that we just got. But we can go to items, and then key. Oh, I see it. There actually is a symbol there. It says coat of arms 1, but in reality it's like, I don't know, key and... Or maybe it is a coat of arms, but it has that symbol that's in front of us. That is not actually Japanese, I don't think. So we stick it in there, and that unlocks this gold rectangle. You could call it a door, but I don't know, it slides upwards. Now, this room is filled with lots of stuff. This thing is a map, if you say so. That will tell us that we are on the first floor. And we can also start picking up some of this health item. Let's go ahead and collect a whole bunch of them. The other interesting thing that you might notice is that there is an AD 1959. That's kind of interesting. What did that say? Oh yeah, this is one of these doors that has this message. Characters are engraved, find the crest. Okay. And this one says, Roku. Sign here. And there's a bunch of signs in the other room. I just skipped them because they weren't relevant. If you don't open from the outside, open from the inside. I think that's telling us that there are some one-way doors or something. Not 100% sure what that is trying to get at. And so far, you know, we're only a few minutes in, but you might notice that this game has a lot of staring at the floor looking for items. My name is Count Saint Germain. Be the one who has eternal life. I will be your good partner. As you can see, we are in a church. Yep, so we followed the cat into the church. We're on the second floor. That's what all that stuff in our HUD means. Take some of that. And we got this guy. He's Cagliostro, a thief who travels through time and space. Thief genius who can see through any trap. Alright. That's him. So this area, as far as I can tell, is pretty much like a tutorial area. We're sort of getting introduced, especially that first room. All those paintings will just tell us one or two sentences about a mechanic, like what an item does, or like that you need to get a key before you continue on. There we go. So that needs a key that has that shape on it. Let's keep looking around. That door moves on. I don't think we're ready to move on. This one's locked. So you might have a feeling, like I did, that this is very similar to like a King's Field kind of environment. We haven't seen any enemies yet, but I definitely get that feeling. This is Simeon. He can predict the future. Considering that part of our HUD is what year it is. Sounds good. I'm waiting for the day to meet you. Okay. I'll see you later, Simeon. Not here to monkey around with you. And then, this is not a person, but rather, this is Prophet Island. And Prophet Island has this red triangle on it. No idea if that's relevant, but it is right there. Yeah, so in terms of our buttons, you know, triangle will open this menu up. We can check our equipment. And when we do, you can see we've got headgear, body, right, left, accessories, and shoes. We can equip things and we can look at things. We don't have any items to look at or equip. So we'll look at that more in detail later on. But the fact that, like, this does not seem like a standard adventure game. It seems more like King's Quest. Not King's Quest, King's Field. King's Quest would be something else. Let's see if they hid anything behind this door. Doesn't look like it. So now we are going to descend. It's pretty much the only direction we can go. And this game does a pretty good job of show not tell. So we're just going to be throwing down a save state. So what do we want to do? We want to go ahead and check our items. And we might as well use a torch. Let's see what the torch says. lights up the dark dungeon brightly. Now, I don't know if this has a limit. The fact it has, like, times one seems to imply to me, at least, that there is a limit. What does it say? Oh, that one's locked. That's rude. Open it. There's nothing. You gotta be kidding me. An empty treasure chest in a game. And so the reason that the torch might matter is... Is that a pit? Is that a pit that's gonna kill me? I think that's a pit that's gonna kill me. So let's not. Instead, let's look at these wall scrolls. The directions are sure. Compass directions are shown. Wait, are they? I don't see any compass directions, but okay. Jumping into a pit and never returning. So I think that's a hint. Do not jump into the pit. Kind of want to, but I'll be good and not jump into the pit. Instead, we'll go check this chest and get this copper ingot, I guess represented by the letter C. I always engrave my things with the first letter of their name. My diamonds all have D's in them. Who wouldn't? So I'm a little bit scared of that pit. Let's walk around that. Ooh. Well, that is a nice chest. Wait, you're saying it's locked? Okay. That's also locked. Okay, so there are three locked chests in this tutorial area. Maybe we will find a key. Maybe we will have to backtrack. Oh, there's a torch right here, too. It is backing up our theory that we will need more than one torch throughout the game. Yeah, the torch is running out. At least, it flickered. Ahead are gas chambers. No entry. Why are there gas chambers in this church? I'll be honest. I kinda wanna enter. Tell me about gas. Gas? No. That smells like gas. Oh! It's painful and dangerous. What kind of gas is this? Iris lost consciousness. So Iris is our character, I guess. And let's get our first death of the game. Now, we cannot jump. I don't think we can jump, right? Nah, it does not seem so. So, like, one of the things I was kind of curious about is whether we could maybe get past just that, like, very short passageway. Maybe with the help of, wait. Are we trying to sequence break this game I've never played before? Yes, that's exactly what we're doing. So we're gonna try this. We can go into our menu and heal. Item. Now let's go ahead and use. These things restore health, I think. No, that cures curses. Okay, cumin cures poison, basil heals me, I think. Oh, it heals me, like, barely at all. Okay. Ooh, that almost worked. Okay, we're doing it. Okay, I think the gas continues farther in, so it's not just those few squares. All right, well, that was interesting to check out. Sounds like we're gonna have to come back to that. Okay, more chests. Is there a chest of gas mask? It's empty. I didn't say anything. That's right. Some paintings. I guess we can read them. What are they gonna tell me? Gas. Those who enter the gas chamber will die. I really want to enter the gas chamber, though. Fragments of constellations pave the way. I guess so. Oh, there's the cat. Hey, cat. And now we are controlled in a cutscene. Schroedinger, are you there? Stay there, don't go anywhere. Ooh, cat animation. Pretty good. Schroedinger, where are you going? Nice. I always like it when I can sort of read it before translation comes in. Why are you running away? Ooh. This looks like part of my interface. It's a map. Got the map. You know, this says I have the map. And yet, why is that red and purple? But there's not really a map. Okay. That thing looks fun. This is the Aquarius, piece. Getting more healing herbs. Here's death. Or the ferryman or something. Somewhere in the room, there's an invisible door. Oh boy. We really are going like Kingsfield, huh? That means I'm just gonna have to like rub up against every wall. Alright, well before we do that, maybe we'll come over here. Maybe I need to pause. There might be a different way to view the map. Let's see. Item, equipment, system. And question mark. Well, if I go to item... It says map. I can see the hole. Okay, let's try using the map and seeing what happens. Put the map in the compass. I can see the hole. Oh. That's actually kind of convenient. Is much more convenient than I thought it was going to be. There's like a dimple in the wall right here, but I don't think that matters. I think these wall dimples are... Wait. What is this? There is something here? I'm hungry. Oh. Wait, I have the hungry status. How do I become not hungry? Do I eat basil? Oh man, I'm so hungry. I could go for like some leaves. Guess we'll find that out. Okay. Saying there's a hidden door. That is the downside of this kind of game. Oh, and now I've come back up. Okay, what is this? Opens a door. I like a good open door. Oh, that's just a shortcut. That's nice. Yep, that's still doing its thing. And here's the Aquarius. Let's see if I have to manually do it. Constellation fragments are designed to be inlaid. Item. Key. Aquarius. Ooh, we've traveled back to 1543. I was surprised. My body was sucked into the light. Just when I thought I was finally out of the light, it seems that this is not the church. Where am I? Smells just like a little bit of the sea. Now let's go find Schrodinger. Sorry to say it, but you're probably about 400 years too early to find that cat. Examine the wall. You gotta be joking. That's your clue? Your clue is examine the wall? Food. I imagine I'm gonna get quite a hankering for some basil. Oh, there's the secret door. Okay. I'm assuming that unlock this door. What do you mean this isn't this? Oh, well, I guess it is a completely different church, huh? Locked. Oh, hey there. Yeah, I saw your face. Aren't you like immortal or something? I forgot already. Saint Germain, always on the side of those who have the right heart. A good collaborator who points out the path that you should take into the futu. He probably said future there. Not the futu. You were warped into another world by the power of the constellation fragments of the church's globe. This is an island called Lower Putrine, far away from where you used to live. The inhabitants of this island speak a language that you don't know, but don't worry. With my power, you'll be able to understand the language of this country. That's pretty cool. You seem to be looking for a cat named Schroedinger. Schrodinger has taken refuge in this town. If you want to find it, go meet Simeon. Oh yeah, I remember Simeon. He's a prophet. He's a famous prophet and psychic who can understand the fate of the world. See you soon, and ask him about the cat you're looking for, Schrodinger. This is the Island of Prophecy. The prophet lives somewhere in the island. Just go see him. Yeah, you already told me that. Sounds a little bit too big for you. It will take a long time to walk the island on your feet. Do this, Legion Boot 1. Wearing these boots will allow you to walk faster. Oh, thank goodness. I've been running just to get to a normal walking pace. Got the Legion boots. When Schrodinger is found, a way out of this world will be found. Okay. So this is actually playing out a little bit like Echo Knight, where it seems like we're going into these eras. I can go ahead and save, maybe. Checking the memory card. Cebu. Yeah, so we go into these little eras, we get a little bit of a storyline, and then when we finish the storyline, we get to return to the hub world. Are you still adventuring? Yeah. I'm still adventuring. I'm gonna keep going for a little bit longer. Be careful. What does this sign actually say? A-E- Edu-ip. Somehow that does not strike me as real words. Okay. Now, we do not have a map for this area, I think. What is this thing? Locked. Roku-kiri-te-iru. Okay. It's locked. And this is find the crest. Oh, is there a crest? Oh, there it is. I need that crest to move on. Okay. We can also just, I don't know, check the pews or something. See if there's anything here. Doesn't look like it. I feel like before I go, though, I do want to just do a once-over on these pews. It's the kind of place where people would hide something if they were a nasty developer. Alright, let's get going. Um, Putrine? I think that said putrine. And we should probably also check our items. Use, rectify, replace. No, I want equipment. System. Oh yeah, system, equip. Let's see. We want to equip our Legion boots. So let's wear boots. Yep. In fact, oh, it won't even let us look at them anymore. That's fine. Okay. Not a huge speed improvement, but it's enough. Probably wise that they do not let me jump. But I have to be honest, I really want to, get around that little boulder. Apparently Iris, at the age of 16, does not know how to swim. And falling into the water is instant death for her. I understand. Not everybody can go to the YMCA. Even though the village people said, you know, it's available for everyone. We're just gonna explore a little bit over here. Okay. For some reason I was starting to think this is a random dead end. Maybe there is a hidden door in the rock face. But maybe I'm getting ahead of myself. I don't think we need to run up against every single wall quite yet. Even though I really did want to skip that gas chamber. That'll be for the Schrodinger's Neko speedrunning community to try. Doing that sequence break. Okay, so this island is pretty big. Definitely gonna give it that. Try the good old follow the right hand wall and just see what we can find. This opens. What room am I in? Somebody's house. That's an empty house. I don't know what you mean by empty. There are these beautiful inhabitants here, like a locked chest. And an empty chest. There's one more chest over here. I'm just looking at these walls. I'm not seeing anything that indicates a hidden door. How about this crate? Can I bust the crate open? Doesn't seem like it. Didn't respond. Okay. So, still one locked chest in the empty house. And I see our map has a red marker. It's purple and red. So let's maybe try the map. Yeah, let's use map. Island. A map is going to be helpful. This building looks possibly interesting. Oh, hey there. Simeon, the prophet. Alright, part one of our quest is done. You don't have to say anything. I already know. My fortune-telling used to say that a girl would come from a faraway country in search of a cat. You're destined to travel to the past and the future around the world, swallowed by the distortions of time and space. Eating only basil. You want to find a cat and return to your original world. Unfortunately, I cannot help. Because someone stole my fortune-telling. Alright, I've got to find his fortune-telling tool. If you give me back my tools, I'll tell your fortune. My fortune-telling tools are a silver dish called Blanche, a brass rod, and a weight of fate. Okay, so he needs a plate, a rod, and a balance. Sure. This artwork is not gonna give me a cryptic clue. What kind of crappy art is that? Artwork in the church always used to give me clues. Your fortune telling is really not very good. Get some talking paintings. Certainly a person. This is Boris's house. Boris Gainsburg. I'm Boris. I see, your name is Iris. He's not the place, he's Boris. It's a face you don't see. How on earth did you come to this island? What do you mean, how did I come to this island? How do you come to this island? This island doesn't even have any farmland, it's just rocks. Huh, you came from the future? I think I saw one orange tree. They probably ended up in this island in a shipwreck or something, but that doesn't matter. This place is called the Crossroads of the Sea because the ocean currents collide. Many things wash up on this island from distant countries, and I live by picking them up. Really? Just living off of shipwrecked food? The thing that washed ashore is mine. Don't take it arbitrarily. I won't let you know if I take it. Okie dokie, dude. You know, I said this looked like Kingsfield, but it's definitely playing out more like Echo Knight. I think the HP threw me off. No secret passages in your house? For shame. What kind of smuggler are you? Basil. You know, I didn't know this, but basil apparently... Ooh, jeez. Almost walked right off of that. Basil, more or less like a weed. Just grows everywhere. It's like rocks out there. It doesn't seem like we can get there yet. In fact, the map seems to sort of be a little bit short for some reason. I don't know why that is. Looks like there is a bridge. Let's go check it out. What is this? Basil. People of the island have set up some very inconvenient pathways to get over here for some reason. What is that? That's not basil. Wait, it's copper. Okay. So they set this whole thing up just to hide a piece of copper on that rock. Getting hungry. All right, I'll eat some basil. Are we at 9 basils? Gotta be careful that we don't, pick up ones that we just have to throw away. I guess let's continue exploring the outside of the island. Instant death ocean water right next to me. I see you. You are cumin. No, wait. Damen? Well, it says it's cumin. The end of the road. Let's go check out the island. Ooh, a cave. My favorite thing to put on an island is a cave. And I got nothing better to do. This is not a cave, this is a tunnel. Somebody dug a tunnel through this mountain? Why? Where were they going? They're like, I have to get to the southern shore as fast as possible. Everybody quickly, let's cut all this stone. This is a major trade route. Got cargo coming in here all day. Alright. What is this amazing thing that they've cut all this rock to get to? Like nothing. There's nothing. Okay. Still no cat. We need 3 magical tools and a cat. That's our current quest. Prophet that can see the future is like, I know. I might one day really need to go take a walk on the southern side of the shore where there is absolutely nothing. Let's dig all these tunnels. But no, we actually did see something on the map. That is up here. That looks distinctly like an icon. And icons mean maybe something good. Okay. A tree. Give me your fruits. Nothing. It's a well. Oh, I drank spring water. Drinking water will make me not hungry. That's good to know. I mean, it's a bit unexpected. I just wanted to check this rock face for some reason. Okay. Well, so that's pretty nice. It's nice to know that there is going to be wells in-game that will give us food. We'll just continue following the right wall here. Naturally, passing by a lot of stuff we could be exploring, but as you said, this island's pretty big. It's gonna take us a while. So let's not get too ahead of ourselves. Check this room. Doesn't open. How are you? Nothing here. Because he said he lost three items, and you know what that tells me is probably they're gonna be in random corners of the map. Such as maybe one on a random beach, one in some random house, that kind of thing. So we are gonna have to explore. I'm wondering about that 50 HP though, and this equipment and all this. What is it all for? It says I can equip things in my arms. Will I fight something? My 16-year-old legs are just too short to jump over this knee-high wall. It's not just high wall. Alright. So I know there's a character there. That's worth checking out. Seems a little silly to have this whole area, but you can't do anything. This is a long coastline to have nothing. So that door does not open. Let's just check this house. Does it open? This one's gotta open, right? Edoga. It's Edgar Anju. Okay. Let's go into Edgar's house. Hey, Edgar.
You're a girl I've never seen before. What's your name? Oh yeah, Iris. That's a pretty name. My name's Edgar. I'm retired now, but I used to love adventures, and I used to do a lot of unreasonable things, if you know what I'm saying. When I was young, I used to walk around every corner of the island and make a map.
Well, give me your map. That's what you're telling me, right? You're telling me you've got a map hidden in here somewhere? Give it to me. Give it to me. Is this it? There's a red box. Is that your map? Look, old man, I'll sleep in your bed if you give me that map.
Looking for Simon's divination tools.
Then meet and listen to various people. I'm sure somebody else knows. But not me. I'm useless. Okay. Edgar, you've lived on this island a long time, and it's maybe time for you to go away. Can't go in. But his hint is basically to talk to people, not to just search random houses and stuff. So, okay. I mean, we can always try that. We can also search randomly. We're now in some random backyard, I guess. So is this why that long path is there? Is like in case I slip? Then I don't instant die, I just go onto like that long path. Okay. I mean, I guess that works. Was indeed a place we could have gone, and there doesn't seem to be anything back here. I do like this music track better than the music at the church, though. It's a little bit cheery. Don't mind me, I'm just walking on your crops. Got any basil in here? I'd like me some basil. I want to check this building over here. Something tells me. Robert Roland. Okay. Hey, Robert, you home? There you are. I'm Robert, a fisherman, but I'm off to work right now. There's a small island to the north off this island. You can catch a lot of fish there. There's a cave in the island. There's a rumor that a terrifying monster appears in that cave. Wait, really? That's why I stopped fishing for a while. I don't want to meet monsters. The ferry leaves from the dock ahead, but it's too dangerous to go now. Huh. Okay, well, I mean, I guess that's useful information. So we can go to the dock to go to an island with a monster on it. don't know why we would want to do that, but maybe the monster has one of the fortune-telling tools. I don't know how it would have gotten it. But, yeah. Okay. Well, so I think that this is probably an okay place to stop. So we've made it into the first sub-story. Story of 1543, and we're looking for a cat and tools. The tools will help us know where the cat is, and once we know where the cat is, we can leave, is, I believe, how this works. And we might have to fight a monster. That'll be interesting. Well, I'm kind of curious about this game. I wanted to play it for about an hour to see how it was, and I think it's to my liking. I was a little bit worried it'd be sort of like Kingsfield, where it was going to be kind of grindy or kind of death-heavy. But so far, it seems like it's more like... Oh, gosh. Yeah, maybe... should make sure I'm paused so that I do not become hungry status. Yeah, it seems like it's more like, I don't know, like Echo Knight. And I kind of found Echo Knight interesting. I haven't played it through, but I found it interesting enough that I watched a Let's Play of it. And there's no Let's Plays of this game that I know of, so I might continue this game. We'll find out. Anyway, that's all for today. Thanks for watching.